Nearly 90% of adults get cavities at some point in their life, and 2% of people between the age of 20 to 64 lose all of their teeth. Cavities aren't random. There are three principles at play that you need to understand in order to protect your teeth and keep them healthy for life. Number one, saliva, your natural defense against cavities. Think of saliva as engine oil in a car. If motor oil runs low or has contaminants, your car is gonna start to sputter, and then you're gonna have problems. Our saliva is the same. If you have dry mouth or you have bacteria in your saliva, that starts weakening the enamel and eventually causing a hole in your tooth. Saliva has a really important role. It helps digest our food by coating it before it enters the stomach. It's made up of mostly water, but it does have calcium and phosphates and other enzymes like salivary amylase to help digest our food. Here's how it works. Every time you put something into your mouth to eat or drink, bacteria feed on those things and release acid as a byproduct. The longer the acid stays on the tooth, the more harm it does. It demineralizes the tooth and making little lesions. If left untreated for a long time, that's when a cavity starts to happen. As soon as you're done eating or drinking, your saliva immediately begins to work. It works by buffering the pH and trying to raise it back to a neutral level. Enamel starts to demineralize at the pH of 5.5. Most carbonated beverages or acidic foods are at a pH of 2.5 or 3.5, way below the threshold for demineralization. It usually takes about 20 to 30 minutes for saliva to work and remineralize the oral biome back to a stable pH. There's one more catch with saliva. At nighttime, when you're getting ready to rest and digest, your saliva production also slows down. Bacteria in your mouth never sleep, even when you are. If you go to bed without cleaning your teeth, you're putting your teeth in jeopardy. And if you struggle with dry mouth, mouth breathing, taking many medications, your saliva is gonna be struggling to keep up, especially when you're sleeping. Before we get into principle number two, you may be wondering, how does a cavity actually start? Well, it's a chain reaction. Bacteria eat sugar that we consume. Doesn't even have to be sugar. It can be simple fermentable carbohydrates. Bacteria thrive in an acidic environment. They release more acid as a byproduct. Over time, the acid starts to dissolve enamel. As I mentioned earlier, enamel is really strong, but if left neglected, you bet it's gonna start to weaken. At its core, a dental cavity is just that, a hole inside your tooth. Saliva works by neutralizing that acidity and breaking that chain reaction. But saliva can only do so much. That's where point number two comes in. Your diet can hurt or help your saliva. And it doesn't take candy or soda to do this. Carbohydrates, proteins, and anything that we can put into our mouth that will feed the bacteria. More than anything, it's the frequency of eating, snacking, and drinking that does the most damage. If saliva doesn't have enough time to keep up with the acid attacks, it's a losing battle. Even health drinks and health foods can cause cavities. Take kombucha or lemon water, for example. Very acidic, pH of 2.5. Again, enamel demineralizes at a pH of 5.5. How do we have our diet work with our saliva and not against it? Pair your sweets and snacks with meals and not hours after you have eaten. Rinse thoroughly with water after coffee, soda, or anything acidic. Chew xylitol gum, an apple, celery, carrot, or some cheese after a meal to help neutralize the acidity. Here's another huge one. Do not brush immediately after eating. If enamel has just been softened by the acidity from the foods we've eaten, by brushing right after you eat, you're wearing it down even more. Waiting 30 minutes after eating or drinking gives our saliva ample time to reharden and protect the surface of our teeth. Saliva and diet play a really important role, but there's one more piece of the puzzle to solving dental decay. And that's what you do at home every single day with your home care. There's no way to protect your teeth without brushing, cleaning between your teeth, or cleaning your tongue. But here's the twist. Timing and when you do this matters just as much as your technique. Brushing at nighttime is the single most important way to protect your teeth, especially when your saliva is not active. Bacteria doesn't sleep. So when you're resting and digesting, bacteria is going to town if you haven't cleaned your teeth before bed. And they'll work on weakening and causing cavities all night long. And then morning comes, you have to rush to work or school, maybe skip a brushing session. You've just extended the amount of time that that bacteria is on there. Use a toothpaste you like, clean between the teeth the way you like, but do it every single day. If you skip a night, make sure you follow up in the morning. Brushing timing is a highly debated topic, so I'm here to shed some light on the truth of what research says is the best. Do you brush before breakfast or after breakfast? If you're in a rush and you need to get out the door, brush before breakfast. Brush your teeth, do do your routine, eat your breakfast, and out the door. If you have more time in the mornings, you can safely clean your teeth 30 minutes after you've had your breakfast, coffee, and tea. Quick recap, saliva, your body's natural defense mechanism. Be aware of it, know what it's doing for your teeth. I know it sounds cliche, but watch what you're eating and how it affects your teeth. The frequency of snacking and drinking matters a lot more than what you're consuming. Candy and sweets are not as harmful on the teeth if eaten all at once versus spread out over a long period of time. Nail your home care, especially at nighttime. Do not skip this if you want to keep your teeth healthy for the rest of your life. And remember this, cavities are not random. There's a chemistry behind how the process works. If you understand it, you're well on your way to protecting your teeth and keeping them for a long time. If you found this information valuable, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and comment down below. I'm always happy to read and answer any questions. If you go back to any of my other videos, you can see I never leave a stone unturned. I answer every single question. Currently, we're on a goal to hit 500 subscribers, and I'll be a happy camper if you're a part of that number. This has been Alex, not a dentist. Stay blessed and refreshed, defend what matters daily, and let the healing begin. See you next time.